Hello and welcome again. I hope you're finding time this week to incorporate relaxation into your routine. Now, in the previous lesson, we learned about the nervous system and ways of soothing the nervous system. Today, we'll talk about a very important aspect of well-being, which is sleep. We all know how important it is to sleep well, yet we find sleep sort of evading us. Because when we work constantly from morning until night, and even though we might be tired at night, I'm sure you might have observed that the brain is not able to switch off sometimes. The mind is overthinking, or we tend to resort to technology to distract ourselves. And it is important to emphasize sleep, you know, as a priority, because that's what leads to well-being. And if we don't do that, it leads to insomnia, imbalanced mental health, anxiety dreams, and also lifestyle disorders of high blood pressure, cardiovascular disorders, and obesity. And as per a study by Fitbit, India is the second most sleep-deprived country. Now, this should be a wake-up call in itself. So we should always stick to the guideline recommended by National Sleep Foundation of sleeping at least 7 to 9 hours every night. Now, we all know this, we've heard about this from, you know, multiple people and multiple sources, but yet we find this difficult to implement. And one way we can simplify this is to create an evening routine built around the principles of relaxation and unwinding. If we aim for relaxation, naturally, sleep is the outcome. And the first step is to eat your dinner early, at least 2-3 hours before bed. Because if you go to sleep with your stomach full, all the energy is going to be spent on digesting the meal. So important to eat a light to moderate meal. Again, not too light, because this might keep you up. So eat a light to moderate meal at least 2 to 3 hours before bed. The second key lies in switching off from technology at least 1 hour before bed. And this includes television, this includes your mobile phones, laptops, tablets, email, social media, WhatsApp, all of it. Because when we do that, the brain begins to disconnect from the outside world, and then the brain waves slow down and the mind relaxes and calms down. Also, the blue light from these devices is what impacts the production of melatonin, which is responsible for the sleep cycle. And the third step is to engage in activities which will help you unwind and relax. And this could mean playing with your children, enjoying with family members, journaling about your thoughts and feelings, about things you're grateful for, reading a book, enjoying some soothing music. All of these activities is what will again activate the relaxation response or the parasympathetic nervous system. And the last 2-3 hours before bed is where we want to really activate this relaxation response, because that's what prepares the nervous system, the brain, and the body for a restful sleep. That's what tells the brain that now the body is preparing for rest and relaxation. So it's important to segregate your day for all your effort and activities, but in the evening, last couple of hours, it is even more important to rest, relax, and unwind. And with this, over time, you'll notice that you're sleeping much more rested. And with this, over time, you'll notice that you wake up feeling rested. And this makes you more productive at work. It makes you more present in relationships and enhances your overall physical and emotional well-being. And the journaling activity for today is to design an evening routine around relaxation. Identify the activities you want to include in your evening routine that will help you feel relaxed and rested and prepared for a sound sleep. On that note, I hope you sleep well tonight. Thank you. Namaste.